Welcome to Crafty Purple Dragon. I wanted to do a post review on this gorgeous beast. This was, let me get it. Where's he gone? This was the second painting in our watercolour series. I had to do him fairly quickly because he's a present for my mum for a birthday. He is a 35 by 35 full round, 30 colour. He's from Oneself Design 001 store on AliExpress. And it cost £8.06. Ordered on the 25th of March and it arrived on the 4th of April. I started him on the 5th of April and finished him on the 12th. Obviously I wasn't doing it like all the time, but I did it over a few days. Now, I really enjoyed doing this. It was a really nice painting. It's a nice size. I think the finished effect is nice. I can just about get him all in screen. The drills were good. I didn't have a lot of problems with drills. This, let me show you my rubbish. That is the extent of my trash, which is probably the best I've had in terms of trash. That's the least trash I've had in a painting that I've done so far. So that was good. Yeah, the quality of the diamonds was good. The problem I've had, I've still got to go around and straighten up some of these lines because I'm still not great at getting them straight, but this is one of those canvases that's really tacky, so sliding the beads around once you've got them down is quite difficult, so lining up some of these is going to be a little bit of a pain, but that's my fault for not putting them down straight to start with. In terms of bead quantity, that was a little bit patchy. Some of them, I've got quite a few bits left. Let me find my drill box. So these are the drills. So for two colours, I still have a bag of each that I haven't even opened. But there are a few others that it was getting quite close. Mostly I've got more or less a good quantity left over, but if it weren't for the fact that there wasn't a lot of trash, I would have been cutting it a lot finer, I think, in terms of, you know, amounts and whether I had enough to do the painting. But as there wasn't a lot of trash, I did end up with enough left over. Apart from, well, look how close that is. That was really close to the bone. Most of them I've got a reasonable amount left. Some I've got quite a lot left. Sorry about that, my battery died. So as I was saying, yeah, most of them I've got a reasonable amount left. Some of them I've got just about enough left, and this one, zero. I got to the last segment down here at the bottom. This last bit here. There were 7 J's. 794. And there were exactly 7 left in the pot. I couldn't believe it. If I'd have had any more trash, because I think I did have a couple of trash. But again, not many. I think this was J colour. So there's about 3 trash in there. If I'd have had any more, I'd have run out. So that was lucky. Yeah, I've enjoyed it. I'm sad it's finished, really, because I did enjoy doing it. Now, I did an unboxing the other day, and it was a different kind of finish. I'm going to use this Deco Art Triple Thick Brilliant Brush on Gloss Glaze for this. But what I'm going to do first is I'm going to go over it with this tool and try and straighten up the rows, because some of them are a little bit wiggly. And when I've done that, I've already cleaned it, actually. But depending on what adhesive I ruck up with this, I might need to go over it again. But I've already been over it with a toothbrush and a wipe to clean off the beads. So I'm just going to do the row thing with this, and then I will put this on it and see how we go. Now, normally with the Mod Podge that I've been using, I have diluted it a little bit. I don't know whether to do that. So this says, create a clear high gloss finish with one coat on hard surfaces. The extra thick glaze adds depth. Directions, use an acrylic brush to apply. Apply multiple coats for additional protection or on textured or porous surfaces. Do not overwork. Allow to dry for 24 hours before use. Acid-free, water-based, permanent. Soap and water cleanup. So, I'm not sure. Let's see what. Oh, it's got a lid on it. I know it's not. Oh, it has, but the lid's cut. Ah! So. Oh! It smells a bit. Oh! Smells a bit like peroxide, actually. I don't know why it would smell of peroxide. Anyway, you can see it's quite shiny. Whether, I'm just hoping that it doesn't take too much off the beads, but I want to give it a go. So there was a lady, I don't know her name, but there was a lady did a comparison of a number of different products, and this was one of them, and it looked quite good, so I thought I'd give it a go. Gosh, I'm making a mess. Right. So overall, I would recommend this picture. Like I said, I thoroughly enjoyed doing it. I think the quality was really good. There was very little trash. And for the most part, there was, you know, some beads remaining. So I had plenty of beads for the project. So thumbs up for this painting for sure. Thanks very much for joining me. If you're a returning subscriber, thank you so, so much for joining us. It's very much appreciated. Us. I say us. I'm me. There's me. That's it. Well, us. Me and Pixie. She doesn't really take much part in it, but, you know, I talk to her, so. And refer to her. So, anyway, thank you very much for joining me. It's much appreciated. If this is your first time visiting, please subscribe and click the notification bell so that you're notified when I upload future videos. If you have any comments, questions, or suggestions, please leave them in the comments section below. And I'll see you next time. Thank you. Bye.